Okay, so I'm going to go through the solutions for this exam. And you can go through them at your own pace and correct any errors you made in the exam, take down the correct solutions, just make sure you understand where I'm getting everything from. Okay, so this question says factorize. Factorize means I'm going to have one of four solutions, which is highest common factor, the highest common factor of groups or by grouping, three is the guide number, which is for trinomials, and then four is the difference of two squares. Okay, so this one here should be easily identifiable as a highest common factor because it's got four terms. Yeah, so it's a grouping highest common factor because it's got four terms. All right, so I'm going to create my red bracket and create my green bracket, and then I'm going to take my red highest common factor, so I'm looking for a number that divides into both, and a letter, which I think is 2r. And then I'm going to divide the first one by 2r, and I'm going to divide the second one by 2r. Sorry, I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. Okay, that's better. Okay, so the 2 divided by 2 is 1. The or cancels the or, and that leaves me with s. Then I have the minus. 4 divided by 2 is 2, the or cancels the or, and I'm left with t. Okay, so then the green highest common factor, I'm going to go with minus 3. So that means I'm going to divide here by minus 3, and I'm going to divide here by minus 3. Now, it's really important. One of the biggest mistakes that was made throughout the paper was signs. You have to read the signs. You can't just ignore them. Okay, so that first division here, I have two minuses, which is a plus. 6 divided by 3 is 2, and then a t. The next one is a plus and a minus, which is a minus. 3 divided by 3 is 1, and I have the s. Okay, so now it's really important that we check if these brackets match. Oh. Okay, and if you look at them, this here is a plus 1s, and this here is a minus 1s. And then this is a minus 2t, and this is a plus 2t. So they don't match. When that happens, what you have done wrong is in the middle. So it should have been a plus 3. Okay, which means I need to change these into plus 3s. And that means this bracket is going to be wrong. Okay, so let's go back to this division. This time it's a minus and a plus, which is minus, and 6 divided by 3 is still 2, and then t is the letter. Then the second one there is a plus and a plus, which is a plus, 3 divided by 3 is 1, and s. So now, on the left, if I just take these off, on the left I have a plus 1s, and on the right I have a plus 1s. On the left, I have a minus 2t, and on the right, I have a minus 2t. So now I have my answers. So we write down the matching bracket, which is 1s minus 2t, and we write down the highest common factors, which is 2r plus 3. Okay, so the marking system on that was 0, 2, 3, 5. Okay, so that means that there were marks going for various attempts at things. So you could get 2 for writing any common factor, and you could get 3 You know my first version of the answer there, where I did the 2 correct common factors, but my brackets didn't match? So if you did that, you can get this. So we'll just say non-matching brackets. Do you know what I mean? So attempts in the right direction. Then there were people I know who got this line here, but they never wrote the final line. So if you stopped here, you get 5 minus 1. Yeah? So anyway, bits and bobs. Okay, this one here, 5a squared minus 125b squared. So it looks like a difference of two squares because it has the a squared, it has the b squared, and it has the minus. However, 5 and 125 are not square numbers. They're not on that list. My square number list, if I put a few of them down, is 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36. What's that? 7, 49, 81, and so on. Okay? So, this is kind of like two factorizing in one. So, what you need to do is you need to get a highest common factor, which in this case is going to be 5. So I'm going to divide by 5, divide by 5. Now, remember when you're doing a highest common factor, that the factor stays here. You do divide by it, but the factor stays. A lot of you got rid of it, and you will lose marks for that. So 5 divided by 5 is 1. Oh, sorry, it's meant to be an A, not an X. 1A squared. And then 125 divided by 5 is 25, just going to give myself a bit more room, b squared. Okay, now, there's a hint in this question, okay, because it said factorize, which is great, because we know we have our four options. This is the hint, fully. It normally implies that more than one factorization method is needed, okay? And if you now look at this, are 1 and 25